Let's talk about that today, mindset. Mindset is so important, man, because it's never about what happens. It's never about what happens. It's always about how we respond to it. And you know it's about how you respond to it because when you speak, welcome. 5.0 Conversations. I'm the host, Mark Williams. And we here up. That's early in the morning, man. That's how we're going to knock these things out. We're going to knock them out either late at night or early in the morning. You know, and I like to get up early just because it's like, it's just me. You know what I'm saying? I don't got to worry about, you know, the sounds of my phone ringing all crazy. You know, animals, birds chirping, the light just beaming in. So I like to get up early and kind of do my work. So yeah, man, these 5.0 conversations, man. We're just going to get on here and just talk, you know, have some good topics for y'all. There's a lot of stuff to talk about underneath the rims of what I got going on. Whether it be life, whether it be basketball, whether it be education, whether it be, you know, kids, whether it be, you know, lifestyle in general. You know, we got a lot to talk about. So just to introduce myself, for y'all who don't know, I'm Mark Williams. From Cleveland, Ohio. And I dedicated my life to this, man. Like, I can't even say nothing else other than that. I dedicated my life to the game of basketball. I went to Montrose Christian High School. You know, great program. You know, great basketball pedigree. Legendary coaching staff. Shout out to Coach Vetter, Coach Shaw, Coach Preet, Coach Jackson, all of those guys. Shout out to my guys, to my boys. You know, 2012, 2013, the game. Number one, Washington Post. 25, ESPN. You know what I'm saying? So we just gonna let them know some stuff that they may not know. Notable alumni: Kevin Durant, Lennox Glazer, Terrence Ross, etc., etc. College: I went to Temple University. You know, graduated there with a degree in business and education as well. Had some good times, had some fun times. College, what they say, is the best of times, worst of times. But I really learned a lot, and it's really like kind of one of the reasons why I do the stuff that I do today. It's because of my experience in college. So from there, I played some years professional. So from 2017 until 2020 when COVID hit. You know, I was playing professionally. And once COVID hit, it just kind of opened the door to do, you know, other things. You know, I have been dibbling and dabbling and coaching and teaching and stuff like that. But, you know, COVID really gave me some time to sit down and just kind of see, like, where my impact was going to, you know, last the longest. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, we're going to be here for 80 years, you know, if you know, Lord willing. But I'm trying to ball for about 100, you know, 1,000, you feel me? So, you know, just, you know, filling stuff out and, you know, experiences and just life just kind of moving into my, you know, moving in my favor. You know, I started coaching and teaching, which opened my eyes to the needs, which, you know, bring us where we at today. So I really do this just to bridge the gap, you feel me? Because I know I was blessed in my basketball experiences to where I went from one high-level situation to another. So when I became a professional, like, in some of the places I was at, I was too much of a professional. You know, I was trying to get in the gym too much. I demanded too much from my players, and it really tricked me out of a position. When I thought that I was just, you know, moving correctly, it was too much for them. So that's just some of the small stuff we gonna go into, you know. So like, for example, for my high school guys, if you hadn't made that team, or if you don't know the coaching staff, if you're not at workouts right now, especially in this town, it's October 28th. If you're not at workouts now, it's September 28th. If you're not at workouts right now, then you're shooting yourself in the foot. You know what I'm saying? We got to build the relationships to where we got some rapport, to where now I can put a name with a face. So where when I go to make cuts, this person been coming every day. I've been seeing them. They've been talking to me. They've been trying to get better. So even if you aren't the best or haven't been playing the best, you still going to have some sort of rapport up there with the coach. You know, so little small stuff. And I just want to help bridge that gap. Because I understand a lot of times, like, especially when I was growing up, I didn't have pros who was reaching back. I don't know if there wasn't no pros in the area. I don't know what the situation was, but it wasn't too many guys who was reaching back who I can get in contact with, who I could tap into their resources, who I could ask questions. You know, I really didn't start talking to other professionals until obviously when I was in, you know, said situations, I was going through it with the people I was going through it with. But I really didn't start to reach outside of, you know, my teammates and immediate, you know, people until I was a professional, you know? And the help that I acquired from, you know, my first year, then when I started talking to people, it boosted me so much in a little span of time. I already know if I was in high school and I was getting, you know, pro insight, we'd be in the league right now. We wouldn't be on Instagram. We're not in this capacity. So really just bridging that gap, man. You know, so from middle school to high school is reaching down, middle school is reaching up, bridging the gap. So you know what to expect. High school to college, same exact thing, bridging that gap. College to professional, same exact thing, bridging that gap. Professional to real world, bridging that gap. You know, because I mean, like, the ball is going to stop bouncing one day for sure for everybody. Some people sooner than others, you know what I'm saying? Some people going to make some money, some people going to, you know, resent the game, you feel me? But it's just like dating, you know? Basketball is going to show you some good times, it's going to show you some bad times, you feel me? But it's all about the experience, it's all about the perspective, it's all about the mindset. And speaking of, let's get into that today. Let's talk about that today, mindset. Mindset is so important, man, because it's never about what happens. It's never about what happens. It's always about how we respond to it. And you know it's about how you respond to it because when you feel certain emotions, you feel those emotions. So when I'm jealous or when I'm upset or when I'm salty, like, I feel it in my stomach. Like, I just feel it. You know, when I'm happy, when I'm ecstatic, you know what I'm saying? When it's going, like, I feel it, you know? So we can't bank on emotions, like, because emotions going to come, they're going to go, they're going to fester, they're going to leave, they're going to flee. They're going to do all of that. But if your mindset is strong and if your mindset is consistent, then you're going to win every time. Because regardless of if it's a bad situation or good situation, and I'm using air quotations because it's all about the mindset, baby. Stuff don't happen to me. It happened for me. Shout out to the brand, by the way. GGT, man. We're going to get into a full disclaimer, full informational. Because y'all been asking for the merch. Y'all been asking for stuff. And y'all been asking what it means. So we're going to get into that, too. That's a side note. And it's the prototype. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to my godmother who cooked this up for me. You feel me? But mindset is important, man, because, like, it's never about what happens. So, like, for example, when I was in college, man, I thought my career was so bad. I look back on everything. I averaged 15 minutes a game. You know what you can do in 15 minutes? 15 minutes is a long McDonald's line. 15 minutes in a basketball game is a nice phone conversation. 15 minutes, like, you could do a lot in 15 minutes, man. 15 minutes is a test. Like, you could do so much in 15 minutes, but my mindset wasn't strong enough, wasn't in the right place to be in capacity to say, you know what? Yeah, I'm not playing 40, but I'm playing 15. And that 15 could parlay into some 20, 25. And a lot of time as an educator, I see that we get upset and we get in our feelings and we don't even know why. We don't even know why. But it's so much stuff. It's so many things that's outside of you that's pulling you this way, you know, pushing you inward, forcing you down, making you small. You know what I'm saying? To where it's like, we don't even understand how to tap in with our emotions. So I ain't gonna talk your head off. I ain't gonna do none of that. This 5.0 conversations, man. We're gonna get into a lot and we're gonna talk about it. But I'm gonna leave y'all with this today. Thoughts become things. The way you move, the way you think, is how your reality is gonna start to physical. You know what I'm saying? It's gonna start to realize, it's gonna start to actualize, it's gonna start to come down from those Akashic records. That's a whole nother conversation, man. This 5.0. Hey, I appreciate y'all. Either way, if you like me, if you love me, it's all support. I appreciate it. Y'all have a good day, man. We're gonna tap back in. Hit me up, man. Let's interact.